Hello, I'm Mark Davis. Welcome to this special edition of Dateline, live from Kiev. It's been an agonising 5 days since the crash of MH17, as all attempts to rescue the bodies here have failed. As we go to air, the train carrying the victims has finally made it to the government-controlled areas. We'll be giving updates as they come. In a moment, we'll hear from the man at the centre of the crisis, Ukraine's Prime Minister. But first, some background on the false hopes, rumours and shocking truths that have marked the last 5 days.
In a nation that has been so damaged by civil war this year, there's still room to grieve for the deaths of others. The Dutch embassy here in Kiev has become a de facto shrine for those who died on flight MH17. Hundreds come here every day to make some gesture of sympathy. It's been a trauma for all involved. Who killed the innocents on board MH17 is still disputed. The main suspects are pro-Russian rebels firing a surface-to-air missile from their stronghold in and around the crash site in eastern Ukraine.
Beautiful boy. We missed him very much.
29-year-old Viktor Oreshkin called Australia home. He was one of 37 Australian citizens or residents killed, including the unbearably sad deaths of young children, like the three Maslin kids from Perth. The pro-Russian separatists of the self-proclaimed Donetsk People's Republic may be innocent of firing the rocket. Or if they did, they may not have known the target was a civilian aircraft. But they indisputably stand condemned of preventing the retrieval of innocent bodies in the field for days. An agonizing stalemate developed immediately after the crash. Hopes the victims could be laid to rest quickly soon faded. After months of a bitter civil war, the government in Kiev had its own troubles stepping down from its battle mindset to allow the bodies to be recovered.
I am not carrying out any negotiations with terrorists.
The foreign minister and his team, key players in trying to resolve the crisis, work around the clock. But the Ukrainian government has stopped short of agreeing to a comprehensive ceasefire.
The separatists say that they would have let you in if you'd have a ceasefire. They're saying you won't do the ceasefire. Is that correct?
We said from the very beginning that we were ready to set up ceasefire around the crash site from the very beginning. Mm. The point is that this site is under control of the terrorists. Yes.
Disgracefully, by the end of the weekend, there were still bodies lying around the crash site. Possessions of the dead were reportedly being looted. Allegations, too, that key evidence was being removed. We tracked down the spokesperson for the separatists to ask why the bodies were still not being moved. But it seems Sunday is a true day of rest in the People's Republic of Donetsk.
Сьогодні вихідний, ви не працюєте навіть в такій напряженій обстановці. Ну, цього не може бути.
Ми не працюємо. Ми люди, нам потрібно теж відпочити.
Do you know this is looking very bad for your movement? The whole world is watching and while there are bodies rotting in a field. And the world wants to know where are those bodies, how are they being treated and when are they coming back?
Ми вже бачимо, цілий світ бачить картинки, які, що тіла гніють на полі. І що з ними робиться, совершенно непонятно.
Я не уповномочена, давайте.
Not authorized.
Доброго дня.
By the end of the weekend, there was finally a breakthrough of sorts.
What's your best prediction of when the bodies will be delivered?
Потяг знаходиться на станції, завантажений, пломбований, але не рухає, тому що є заборона бойовиків, вони його там оточили і не дають йому рухатись.
The train carrying the recovered bodies has now departed. The past 24 hours full of agonizing false starts as more fighting broke out in the areas surrounding the train. The innocent victims still pawns in this ongoing war game.
Reports are that the train has now arrived in the government-controlled area of Kharkiv after an eight-hour delay following fresh outbreaks of shelling between government and rebel forces. I spoke with Ukraine's Prime Minister Arseniy Yatsenyuk just as the train was readying to leave the rebel areas.
Well, thanks for your time, sir. I greatly appreciate it. Why have the separatists been so belligerent, in your opinion? Is there a strategy at work here?
Let me start with the words of my deepest condolences to your nation, to your people. And we stand by Australian people, Ukrainians mourn and pray for all families who lost their beloved in this despicable act of violence. We launched an investigation, and the question you raised, frankly, has no answer. Mm. Well, I will try to answer. Because
the violence was one thing, but the extra trauma has been these days and days of bodies, people's families in the field.
They are just bastards. Mm. You can't name these beings as a human beings.
You've been critical of Russia in the lead-up to this, but in the post-crash period, could Russia have done more to allow the teams in? I mean, did they have any influence here?
Russia did nothing to allow rescue units and rescue teams to get to the crash site, to stop looting that these guerrillas did in the last few days,
looting,
to de-escalate.
Looting of the bodies or the possession.
That's awful. That's disgusting and awful. I was shocked with this footage.
The Russians, of course, have blamed you for escalating the tensions, in fact, escalating the fighting that led to the crash itself. Is that an accurate description?
The fact is that Russia supplied lethal weapon to Russian-led terrorists. The fact is that MH17 was downed or shot down by the anti-aircraft missile system surface-to-air. The fact is that this anti-aircraft missile system is Russian-made. The fact is that only well-trained agents can operate this system. Mm. This is an international crime. This is the global threat. And we are to bring to justice everyone responsible, including those who are and were behind the scene, those who supplied the weapon, yes, and those who trained these Russian-led guerrillas. And this is Russian Federation.
What happens next? Is there likely to be an escalation of hostilities here?
This is the key priority for the entire globe. To stop this. To stop Russian invasion. And to contain Russia. Because you know what happened? MH17 is just the end of the story. But how it started? It started with an annexation of Crimea, with the grab of land of an independent country, with the violation of international law, with the violation of the UN Charter by P5 member, with sending troops and agents to Ukrainian territory, with a supplying weapon, with the conquering and invading of independent country, and with an idea of restoring the Soviet Union, launched by President Putin. As far as I see, this is his final goal, this is his ultimate goal, to recreate the Dark Empire. This is the global job. and the duty of everyone in this world.
The international community has been very supportive of Ukraine over the past week, certainly with their statements and their words. Do you think that level of interest will remain when this immediate crisis is over?
Well, we have to be frank. The world have a number of things that needs to be resolved and fixed. Syria, Middle East, Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, Ukraine. Who is to be on the top priority list? It depends on the situation. But what we do understand that Ukrainian case or Ukrainian-Russia tension is one of the key threats to the global security. And we need to act in concert, the entire global community, to de-escalate the situation and to bring to justice those responsible for this escalation.
Well, finally, what's your what do you anticipate? What do you think will happen next? What's the mood here amongst your government about what will happen next month?
My government will do everything for peace and stability.
It doesn't feel like what I hear. It doesn't feel like the mood here. There seems to be a lot of anger. There was a lot of trauma when the plane came down. Now there seems a lot of anger. Do you think there's going to be peace and stability, or do you think there's going to be more assaults?
But to get peace, you have to fight. This is the formula.
On that ominous note, thanks for your time.
Thank you, sir.
And it seems the Prime Minister's mood is completely backed by the government here. Just a few hours ago, the Parliament called for an additional call-up of 40,000 soldiers. They've declared Russia's support of the rebels in the east of the country to be a formal act of aggression and have asked for international assistance.